How are you?
Good, how are you doing?
Good.
Well, that's a voice I've heard before.
Well, hello, sir.
Dave, this is my girlfriend, Kate McMillan.
Hi.
Hi, how are you? So, say hi to Barbara Katie.
Hi, Barbara.
Can you show us around?
Sure, come on in.
Oh, you're gonna get the full tour.
Okay, if you stand right where the yellow footprints are and look way back up through the hatch, you'll see the light.
Oh, can I go up there?
No, ma'am.
What if I give you a dollar?
Yeah. If she became a docent, you see, then at Christmas time, there may be a way to get up there.
That's what it looks like up there.
Oh, sure. Just give us a picture.
Yeah. Great. Barbara, it's really easy to see. This is a level 4 Fresnel lens.
It's a what?
The Fresnel lens.
Is?
Is. That's what it's called. It's from France.
It's from France.
Back in the 1800s. The one that's up there now came here in 1915.
1915?
Yeah. There was an original one in 1880.
Right.
That was a level 5. It only went out, the light source only went out 10 miles.
Oh.
So they put a little bit more powerful one in here in 1915, and it goes out 17 miles now.
Wow. That's really cool. What's in this room?
In this room over here.
Am I allowed to go in that room?
Sure you can. That's where the light keeper is workstation. That's where he does his paperwork.
That's not his office. Was he a short person?
See this guy right here?
Yeah?
He was the first light keeper.
Okay.
He's from Seattle, and he was a dentist, and decided he wanted to become a light keeper.
But these people, what was the name of their dog?
I don't know.
Those people there, they have a dog. What was his name?
That was the second one. This one is, I don't know whose dog. She was kind of known here because when he got sick during his stay here, she took over everything, and then she also became the first postmaster for Hansville.
Wow, what was her name?
Mary.
Oh, okay. There's the Sklallam chief. Chimacoma woman. Chimacomish woman. Basket. The Sklallam, Chimacomish, and Chimacoma is point no point first. And they had more rights to this place than any other people. And they got $1.50 for their land rights. And when they figured out how much that wasn't, they were really mad.
How are you today?
Hi, thank you. How about
you? Now, you step back just a minute where you were right there in those yellow footprints.
Yeah.
And look up. Now, watch back. You can go way through your head back. You can see the hatch. And you can see the light up there.
Yeah. I see it. You guys go up and clean it sometimes?
Well, it's actually not used anymore. It's been replaced by the little guy on the corner there, the modernized one. And it's really a museum piece as such. So
no one has to clean it.
No, they don't have to do anything. It actually doesn't work. It could work if they wanted it to, but
well, it would be nice if it did, but yeah.
You know, technically he does do windows.
He does do windows? Oh, wow.
Thank you.
This is it? This is what you do?
Yeah, that's me.
This is really exciting, Al. I'm going to take Barbara Katie back outside. We're going to go. So tell me something else while I'm waiting to get through.
We have some moisture damage here to the brick. This window here has been replaced. That's an original window.
Why is there a towel on
this? Because that one leaks.
There's a towel on this one. Do they have a historic architect looking at it?
Well, they have an historical architect looking at it.
Historic. He's also a historic himself.
Oh, he dates back to the 1950s.
I'll see you soon.
Okay.
Yeah, well, yeah, Walmart's ran a compressed air. This was a backup generator in case electricity went out.
Oh,
and this is what they used for backup generator.
Is it oil? Gas?
It's diesel.
Diesel.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? Yeah.
Just bring the dogs out.
Who made the generator?
I'm not sure who the manufacturer was. It says Gladstone. Say bye to Barbara Katie. It's his cousin in Oregon. Cousin. Oh,
it's his cousin in Oregon.
Yeah, Oregon.
We make videos and post them on Facebook, on YouTube for her, and she watches them in Oregon.
Oh, how fun.
Yeah, it's fun. Okay, now we're outside. Sometimes they have seals and sea lions down there and orcas. I don't know if they have any orcas today, but they got people and they got dogs. And they have walking paths and a bird sanctuary over there in the saltwater marsh, the wetland. Nobody's allowed to really, you can use the trails, but you can't really go into it. So this is the beach, and the lighthouse is on my left. See, there it is. Al has so much fun doing this. Do not feed the seals and sea lions. Again. Where is he? There he is. some nice little wild roses that they have around here. Very nice. Where are they? There it is. It smells real good right here. Pretty much goes on and on like this, and if you look up, I don't know if you can see, it's pretty bright. There's the lighthouse. And that's Hansville. Hansville Church. And then there's the beach over there. And then we're gonna go back this way.